Well, Pastor, I've been reading through the book of Revelation, and it has all these strange creatures, and evil just seems to be running amok, and I feel threatened. Yet you say that's not what it's about?
I mean, certainly the book of Revelation has a lot of symbols in it that can be hard to understand and seem scary if you don't know what they're referring to. But ultimately, the book is one of hope. It's about how God remains faithful to God's people and to the promises that God has made, and how even in the midst of a world that is chaotic and has evil in it and has hardships and dangers and issues, how God's people can continue to worship through that. And so there's worship all throughout the book, and visions of how God is working to restore creation even in its fallen state, and how we can participate with God in that, and ultimately ends in a vision of God dwelling with God's people in a great, beautiful, holy city with its gates wide open, and God bidding everyone to come.
Whoa, wait a minute. You're saying that everyone can get into heaven's gate?
The end of the book, and which is the end of the Bible, ends with this vision of the holy city of God and God's people. And it says the gates are wide open and always open all day, and there's no night. And God and the church bid come and say, anyone who wants to come, come. The gates are open. Come inside and receive life at its fullest and experience what life in God is like. And so through the very end of the Bible, the message is come and there's room here, and come and experience what life in God is like.
I'm still confused. Is it okay if people call you or contact you to talk about this some more?
Yeah, of course. I actually really love talking about this stuff, and so I'd love to talk more about it, and I'd even buy a cup of coffee and talk about it.